Back in the day, when we saw, first saw a preacher, I don't know if ever, Pastor Greg ever been through this. The pastor was just writing the Bible up, opening it. And, you know, you go to your script, he said, don't preach on this script. One Sunday, Pastor, when you open up, I'm just going to go to that script right there. They always used to tell us that you ought to be able to bring a message from anywhere. You know, I was just reading over because that's what he had turned it to. I said, God, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Woo! Thank you, God. Sunday school was great, y'all. Y'all didn't miss it. It was great. I thank God for the word. The word is the one that's going to get us up out of here. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. It's going to keep us grounded. Keep us rooted. Amen. Keep us planted. Amen. I'm not going to be for you very long. I think we already had church. I thank God for Pastor Gregory bringing me up. Amen.
Amen.
I just don't want to come to church on his son. I want to come to church on everybody. And I think he already hit it right there, so I ain't got to go back over that no more. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's go to Jude. Amen? Jude, the first chapter. It's the last, the second book, last of the Revelation. I like all the books of the Bible. You know the Old Testament is for our test master, amen? But it's always good to go to the New sometime. Amen? Just going to give you my topic, so I don't want to forget. Content for the faith. And if I had a subtopic, it would be a faith walk. I'm going to read a couple of verses. I'm going to say right here, I'm not going to move. I could go to a lot of scriptures, but I think y'all will get the message. Jude chapter 1 started verse 1. Jude, the servant of Jesus Christ and the brother of James, to them that are sanctified by God, the Father, preserved in Jesus Christ, and called, mercy unto you and peace and love be multiplied. Beloved, when I give all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you. It was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that you should earnestly contend for the faith which was once delivered unto the saints. Read verse 3 again. Beloved, when I give all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that you should earnestly contend for the faith which was once delivered unto the saints. Once delivered unto you. Unto the saints. Amen? And we know Jude wrote this book. And he had some help along the way. Amen? And it was really writing to the church. We are in church. And it's for the saints. And we know he was writing and he was telling them to continue in the faith that once was delivered unto you. Meaning that when you first got saved, or that you got saved today, meaning that you need to walk therein as of today. No longer looking back on what happened unto you yesterday. Or what you had left at home and you didn't forget it, you didn't bring it to me, whatever. But once delivered unto you, unto the saints. And we know a lot of times, I think it's in Timothy. Paul told Timothy, go on down there to the other churches and preach what I already taught you. forget what I taught you. Preach what I taught you. I don't care if they came in a different way and tell you a different story, but preach what I already said. Then I'm going to go down to the fourth verse. It says, for there are certain men crept in unawares, who were before of the old ordained to the condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lavishness and denying the only Lord God and our Lord Jesus. He said, men that crept in, meaning they have crept in the church. Now we say everything goes. Whatever is good is good for the church. Everything is not good for the church. And we all say we love praise to God, or we save, and some of us say we save and filled with the Holy Ghost. But you know, I was looking at the scripture on last night, late into the night. I was looking at it, I was like, Lord, well, it ain't the sinners that bring the mess in the church. It's the saints. And sometimes we get so caught up in ourselves and our daily duties that we forget about God. That we forget about our upbringing. We forget about what Pastor Jackson has taught us along the way. He taught over some 40-some years, I know, because he's 80-some now. And when we said that they're pressed into the church, meaning, well, we want people to come to church. We do. We want you to come to church. We want you to be delivered. We want you to be set free. But when I read my Bible, it did not tell me that Paul took down. It did not tell me that Moses took down. It did not tell me that Jeremiah took down. It did not tell me none of these men of God took down. It didn't tell me that Ruth took down. All these men and women of God, they lived the life so that we can live it on today. Meaning, whatever the pulpit offer us on today, that means we must obey by the laws. The Bible says obey the laws of the land, meaning at this day and hour, right now, that we're supposed to be obeying God's word. Living by God's word. Doing what God's word is. A lot of people say, I don't know what God's word is. The reason you don't know is because you don't come to church. The reason you don't know, you don't read the word. Every day you ought to open up the scripture and read something. Read a word from God. Yes. Get an answer from God. Yes. You don't have to call up nobody. You can get in your own word. Right. But when I look at it, we say anything goes. But that's not salvation right there. Amen. Salvation don't take anything goes. Yes. We say it's the dresses. No, it ain't the dresses. And sometimes when things have crept into our church, because we have brought it into our church. And we want to incorporate it into our church. I heard a pastor say a while ago, we need a corporate praise. Meaning that means everybody needs to get up and praise God. Yeah. Not just one person, but everybody. Yeah. I can't move if I just have one leg. Yeah. I need both of my legs to move. Yeah. I can't clap if I got one hand. I need both of my hands to clap. Yeah. It needs the whole body of Christ to get on the same page.
Yeah. Amen.
He's not talking to some of y'all, just the whole church.
Yeah.
But he didn't say me, so he ain't talking to me. No, you got it wrong. He said the whole church needs to go on a fast.
Yeah.
But now we got our own picks to choose. Well, that ain't for me. You'll read one part of the scripture, then you'll go down and skip all the other scriptures.
Well,
and go to the last one. That's the scripture for me. And that's what's wrong with the church today. We need to stop packing up the scripture and read all the scripture all the way down. If it said pay my tithe, then it was talking to me.
Right.
If it told me to live right, it was talking to me.
Yes.
If it told me to love my neighbor, it's talking to me.
Yes.
All of that was talking to me.
Yes.
But now you say, it's other people. What about you?
Well,
have you always lived right?
No.
No. Have you always did things right?
No.
No.
And sometimes we always say, well, he talked about fornication. I ain't said nothing about fornication.
Amen.
No. Sometimes it's just little things, these little things that's holding us up.
Yes, yes.
It's the little things.
Yes.
The Bible says it's the little parts that short of garment.
Yes.
It ain't nothing about big parts, it's the little parts.
Yes.
said it over and over again. I said, it ain't the sinner. They ain't coming in here destroying the church. It ain't them off the street. It ain't the crackhead. It's not the drunkard. It's not the prostitute. But it is us. We need to say, Lord, it's us, Lord. That ain't in the need of prayer. It's not my brother, Lord, but it's me, oh Lord. That ain't in the need of prayer. And we wonder why people can't get saved. We wonder why people ain't coming to church. We wonder why people just pass out of the church. Up. When we got many churches on the corner, they can be blessed right here. But if you come to church, and if you do right, people will follow you too.
Yes, ma'am.
Looking for a church home.
Yes, ma'am.
A lot of people looking for a way out.
Yes.
A lot of people are troubling in their mind.
Yes.
Because they've been hurt in the church.
Yes.
And you wonder why things are prepping in. Because we done took on a whole nother way. Now, long as we make them feel comfortable, they'll be alright. Long as we can buy, but you can't buy salvation. It's already free. Well, give me something else to buy. You know what I like about them? They stick together. When it comes down to us, we don't stick together. You ain't got no palace. And you sure don't got no horses. I'm happy.
said that door is cool, you need a buddy buddy system. And I said, what is that? What is a buddy buddy system?
Yeah.
So, you know, like when she was younger, they had to go to the bathroom together. The girls was with the girls.
Right.
You have to be on the safe side. Somebody come in, they is a group of them.
Right.
Yeah.
But now we just got buddy buddy in the church.
Yeah.
As long as I close the pastor's prayer, it's gonna be all right. He got to tell me the truth too. Anybody ever been there? Anybody ever? But you done pulled it out.
All right.
It's bad when sin can creep and walk and walk you down. And you wonder why, Lord, I'm saved, but you ain't doing right. It's a difference.
Right there on the church where I said,
told him, after you get divorced,
crown.
Yes.
And when they told her, I was like, woo, Jesus. Uh-huh. I felt that. But a lot of times, we are, some of y'all don't have a problem with men. I did. Some of y'all got a problem with us and y'all steal, y'all cheat, y'all lie.
Tell somebody.
We're talking about listen. You do all that undercover mess. And you wonder why you got to have this bill to pay that bill.
Yeah.
Go on down and pay one bill, got $100. Now you know all the bills, $100 ain't going to do a bill. Anybody got feelings here?
Well,
$100 already gone. Now your money guy is gone.
Yes.
It's already gone, mother. Already gone. The little things is what destroying our church. It's the little things. I don't like her hat. Put you all in her face. It's the little things.
Yeah.
I don't like her shoes. But I like her man's shoes. That's probably. Yeah.
Yes.
I don't like her husband, but I like his wife. The little thing that's perfect.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I don't like what Pastor said, but I'll take what Mother said. You got a problem. Thank you, Jesus. And we wonder why we can't get saved. Some of y'all need to be saved all over again. And then on top of that, you need some Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
That's it. It'll show you how to love.
Yeah.
I'm going to say this because I don't have no problem. I don't have a problem. And don't try y'all go home and try to read about it. Because it ain't going to be on the newspaper. Sister Ashley, will you let me say this? Y'all was the son as I said to her. So that we glad to see you. I said, what you doing sitting way back there? Come on up here, sit right there. I think she was having a bad day. Then I got a bad day too. I had an attitude. But when you save, you get over your attitude. So I was mad at that lady when I talk to her. Motherfucker, I said, No. I ain't talking to mother either. I was mad. I was like, all I said was. But you see how the Holy Ghost, how the devil is creeping in?
Mm-hmm.
Just from a little something?
Yeah.
And I was like, Lord, I didn't mean it no harm. But guess what? My spirit has got back now. I got attitude in my own sex.
Yes.
Yeah. So I had to go home and pray. Okay, Lord. Okay. I said, okay, Lord. I said, okay, Jesus, then. Why I always gotta do this? Why I just told God, why I always gotta do something? Y'all ain't never gotta do nothing? Woo. So, I went home and I prayed about it. I didn't want to talk to Ashley. I didn't want to go outside the church, drive the church, back of the church. I didn't want to talk to her. But the Holy Ghost, one day I went to work, said, you wrong with two left shoes. And I turned around in the middle of the job and I said, and the Holy Ghost said, no, I'm talking to you.
You're talking to it.
Yeah, you do.
And I got mad again, mother. heart. And we have two of the greatest ones right here.
Amen.
Things have kept in the church because we have brought it in the church. I'm not going to talk about it. The devil did. No, you did. You brought it in the church. And we wonder why people come and go. When you wonder why you ain't healed. You wonder why you ain't set free and delivered. Because you keep on the same mess. Something happened last year, let it go.